Porn performers debate sex addiction doctor. That's me, Dr. Trish Leigh. Welcome, because I'm going to break down the six main discussions that I had with porn performers this past weekend. So I was on a show called The Middle Ground on Jubilee Media. It was totally awesome, really great experience, and I have so much respect for the people who put the show on. So let me say that first and foremost.
To the left, we have Team NoFap, and to the right, porn stars. This should be interesting.
But we had such in-depth discussions. And of course, there was a lot that I added and I had to say, but there was a lot I didn't get to say, or I chose not to say, might be a better way of saying it. That's why I'm here. And I'm going to present to you six different parts of the conversation. So first and foremost, go watch the Jubilee show if you have not yet entered into porn addiction recovery. Now, I want to give you a trigger warning. If you're part of my community and you've already embarked on a porn addiction recovery journey, likely you don't want to watch that episode in its entirety if you find it triggering for you. And if that's the case, you can listen to it, because I think it should be pretty listenable in terms of, you know, I'm aware of how triggers work. So I think you should be able to listen to it if you want to. And I would encourage you to do that. And if not, stay with me here, because I'm going to break the whole thing down and I'm going to add a lot to it. Okay, so the first thing I want to say is that the cast that Jubilee Media put together was very thoughtful and intentional, and every person that was there brought a different perspective to the conversation. So it was NoFap people, including myself. And again, do I characterize as NoFap? I explained it that, you know, I believe in healthy sexuality. So some people in the NoFap community really go hardcore monk mode and they believe in not engaging in sexuality at all. So I'm a little different in that from a neuroscience perspective, I want people to not engage in unhealthy sexual behaviors, which we will talk about. And it's mostly about finding that connection with another person and real world intimacy and being able to enjoy sexual satisfaction and gratification in the context of a relationship that feeds your soul. That's what I'm here to talk about. So on my side, there were two gentlemen who identify as NoFap proponents.
I was going to say, yeah, I would agree with what he's saying about it being a net negative on society. We have higher rates of depression and anxiety in younger men, a lot of which can be associated to compulsive sexual behavior.
They were very heavily invested in religion, which, of course, I have nothing wrong with. I think that's a beautiful thing. And they both are Catholic. And I grew up Catholic, so I have, you know, a full understanding of that. They were talking about the moral aspects of the journey, and I tried to connect the morality to the neuroscience, and we will talk about that. Then those two are on my left, so I'm sure I will keep referring to those two gentlemen over here. They were really nice. We talked after the shoot. We weren't allowed to talk at all before we started shooting. On my right was a gentleman who I'm pretty sure I burst out laughing when he said this in the show, which, you know, who knows if that's appropriate, but he characterizes himself as a former backup porn performer.
I actually used to be a background porn actor.
So like, background porn actor?
Yeah.
What's the difference between regular and background?
So regular is, the regular folks is f***ing, but like, but I wasn't f***ing. And I was just the actor in the scenes.
That's what I'm like, what is that? Backup porn performer? So he was explaining it, but he said he filmed about 10 videos as a backup porn performer. And when he realized how contrived it was and that there was actually no sex going on, it was a performance that was being crafted by directors and there's cameras everywhere. And really nobody on the set was actually sexually enjoying themselves, that he was disillusioned, is the way he put it, is that he no longer could buy into the illusion of porn, and then he stopped watching porn. He wasn't hardcore, like, anti-porn. He's just like, the illusion of porn was ruined for me, so I could no longer participate in it, nor could I consume it. He talked about hookup culture a lot, which is another aspect of hypersexuality we'll break down. To me, he was kind of comic relief. I really enjoyed him a lot. We homied up a bit while we were recording, and the way Middle Ground works is, you know, you're at stools with the moderator, and then each side has to go back under the lights and then step forward again if you agree with the prompt. The ones that I'm going to share with you here.
Post nut clarity, I'm going to be borrowing.
Oh, I know.
And rub it out. Oh, shit, what am I doing?
Will the agreeers please step forward?
And whenever we would go back to the lights, he would say that he's enjoying watching me cook. And I was so stressed out. I was very nervous about it, which is uncharacteristic for me. And I think it's because normally I'm able to say whatever I want to say when I want to say it to be able to fully make my point. And, you know, I didn't want to be the person who was talking all the time, which honestly, I still talked a lot. And if I'm guilty of anything, it's being too sciencey, but that's the role that I played there. I was the science person. On the other side were four horn performers. The first gentleman who identified as a large black male gay porn performer. So, and the reason that's important is because he talked about how he was able to find community in the porn industry, and we'll talk about that. But that's how he identified. There was two women performers, two female performers, and a male performer. Honestly, I really liked him, and I think he and I connected intellectually. I really respected his emotional intelligence to a level. So that's what I also appreciated about the cast, because the one woman, you know, didn't really seem to be thinking too deeply about these concepts. The other woman, these are my opinions, so just so you know, the other woman kind of tapped into like a distorted thought process of the porn industry and her role in it. That's my opinion based on what I know in my education. We're going to break it down. So that's the cast. Two women, a heteronormative male, a gay black male, and two nofap people, me, and then we have our former backup porn performer. It was a really cool cast. So now join me as we continue through this series, because I'm going to go through it prompt by prompt, talking about what the conversation is that we had and the things I didn't get to say. So join me as we go to the first prompt, which is, I was addicted to porn. I'll see you there.